So good morning friends, this is Tarun Nanwani and I welcome you to my channel Sweet Nectar. So today I will give you review of one of my favorite books, The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari. Now in this book all the wonderful lessons are hidden which will be of immense help to all of us. Now the story begins with the main character Julian. Now Julian was a very successful lawyer. He had all the riches in the world and along with it, he had his favorite Ferrari. But look, I mean, although he had all the comforts in his life, Julian was not very happy. He felt that something was really missing in his life. And things got only worse when one day, in the middle of the court, he suffered from a severe heart attack. Now Julian realized that all the comforts and luxuries in the life were of no use to him. So he decided to sell all his property along with his favorite Ferrari and go to the Himalaya. So when he went to the Himalaya, he met a sage named Yogi Raman. Now Yogi Raman told him, "Look Julian, I will tell you about all the secrets of the life which will transform your life. But the only condition is that you need to spread these messages to all the people once you go back." And Julian agreed to it. Now Yogi Raman told him, "Imagine that there is a beautiful garden and behind that garden there is a lighthouse and out of that lighthouse comes a sumo wrestler. He is wearing a diamond studded watch and a very tiny underwear. Now suddenly the sumo wrestler falls on the ground and after some time he smells the fragrance of a beautiful rose and he gets up. And gradually, he walks towards the road beside him." Now friends, you will ask me that what has a garden, a lighthouse, a sumo wrestler, diamond studded watch or a underwear or of a rose, I mean what has these to do with it? Okay, no problem. One by one I will tell you all of these because all of these symbols, they have a definite purpose, definite meaning to it. So now let us pick up the first symbol, which is garden. Now what does the garden mean, right? So garden means our mind, garden means our thought. So what the author explains us about garden is that allow your mind to accept just the positive thoughts. Don't bother about the past or over the bad experiences as there are no bad experiences but only lessons. If you want to live your life to the fullest, stand guard to the gate of your mind and don't allow negative thoughts to enter. If there is a lack in your life, it is just because of lack in your thoughts. Now the author has given few very good techniques to help us master our mind. So one of the technique is the heart of the rose. So you need a fresh rose and a silent place to perform this. Start to stare at the center of the rose, its heart. Notice its color, texture and design. Savor its fragrance and think only about the wonderful object in front of you. At first your mind will wander away. This is the sign of an untrained mind. However, you need not worry. Return your mind to the object of your focus. It gets better with daily practice. Soon your mind will grow strong and disciplined. Spend 10, 15 or even 20 minutes daily to perform this technique. Now the second very good technique which the author explains us is opposition thinking. Yeah, whenever any undesirable thought occupies your mind, immediately replace it with a uplifting one. It is as if your mind is a giant slide projector with every thought in your mind being a slide. Whenever any negative slide comes up on the screen, take swift action to replace it with a positive one. Right? So this was the second technique. And the third technique is the secret of the lake. This technique was applied by the sages. The sages would look into the waters of the still lake and envision their dreams becoming reality. It is also similar to visualization. Everything is created twice, first in the mind and then it is realized in a physical form. We can visualize everything that we want to be, do or have. So now let us go to the second symbol. Do you remember the second symbol? The second symbol is the lighthouse which is behind the garden. Right, now the lighthouse means that we should follow our purpose. So in the previous times, lighthouse was used to give direction to the ship. Now, lighthouse means, as I said, follow your purpose. Discover the true purpose of your life. Set clear goals to achieve it and have the courage to act upon them. A life without purpose is a life wasted. Never do anything because you have to. The only reason to do something is because you want to and because you know it is the right thing for you to do. Now the author has given a couple of very, very good techniques to achieve this. One of the techniques is the power of self-examination. Know your goals. Write it down on paper. Goals that are not written down are no goals at all. The second wonderful technique is the 5-step method for attaining goals. Step 1 is to have a clear vision of your outcome. Step 2 is to create positive pressure to keep you inspired. The third step is a simple one. Never set a goal without attaching a timeline to it. Step 4 is to stay with your goal for 21 days. Any activity you do for 21 days at a stretch, it will subconsciously become a habit. And the final step, step number 5, is to enjoy the process. Now let us go to the third symbol. The third symbol is, if you remember, the sumo wrestler comes out of that lighthouse. Now what does that signify? Now that means practicing Kaizen. Now what is Kaizen? To practice Kaizen means attaining self-mastery through continuous self-improvement. So Kaizen means continuously self-improvement. So you have to improve yourself regularly. Challenge yourself and don't restrict your limits. Identify the things holding you back. Once you have identified what your weaknesses are, next one is to face them and attack them. Fears are nothing more than a negative consciousness. Now again, the author has given a lot of techniques to practice Kaizen. So let us go one by one to all of them. The first one is do the things you fear. Do the things you fear and death of the fear is certain. Then the second is the 10 ancient rules, rituals for radiant living. Right, so he has given us 10 ancient rituals for radiant living. So first one is a ritual of solitude. So spend 15 to 20 minutes daily for a time of silence and peace to know who you really are. Then ritual of physicality. As you take care of your body, so you take care of your mind. As you prepare your body, so you prepare your mind. As you train your body, so you train your mind. Take some time every single day to nourish the temple of your body through vigorous exercise. Another technique is ritual of live nourishment. Fill your plate with fresh vegetables, fruits and grains. Then ritual of abundant knowledge. So read regularly. Reading for say 30 minutes a day will do wonders for you. But do not read any subject matters. Be specific and focus. And then ritual of personal reflection. Review all you have done during that day. Find the wrong action that you have committed and find a way to solve it and not to repeat the next day. Find the right action you did during that day and savor it more. Then ritual of early awakening. Rise from your bed as the sun is rising. You do not need to sleep 8 hours a day. The key thing is to improve the quality of your sleep and get up early every day. Then ritual of music. Never forget the power of music. Spend a little time with it every day. Even if it is listening to a soft music on a cassette while you drive to work, when you feel down or weary, play some music. It is one of the finest motivators. Then ritual of spoken word. Develop a positive self-talk. Use it anytime you want for any purpose you want to achieve. Words transform your life. Then ritual of congruent character. Take daily incremental action to build your character. Strengthening your character affects the way you see yourself and the actions you take. The actions you take come together to form your habits, and this is important as your habits lead you to your destiny. You sow a thought, you reap an action. Reap an action, you sow a habit. Sow a habit, you reap a character. So a character, you reap your destiny. Wow, excellent. Now, ritual of simplicity. Live a simple life. Reduce your needs and be content with less. So now let us jump to the next symbol. Now if you can remember that when the sumo wrestler comes out, what is he wearing? He is wearing a very very tiny underwear. So now what does that signify? Wearing this tiny underwear, we realize that we have to live with discipline, right? I mean, what if the underwear, you know, slips down, right? So we have to make sure that we live a disciplined life and we do not slip. It is very important to build your willpower. To build a will of iron, it is essential to take small steps of personal discipline. Lack of willpower is a mental disease. An abundance of willpower and discipline is one of the chief attributes of all those with strong characters and wonderful lives. Now the author has given few very very good techniques for that. One of them is repeating mantra or creative envisioning. Repeat this mantra at least 30 times a day. Something like, I am more than I appear to be. All the world's strength and power rests inside me. See yourself as a disciplined, firm person, fully in control of your mind, your body and your spirit. Picture yourself acting as Gandhi or Mother Teresa might act in a challenging situation. The second technique is the vow of silence. Spend some time or a full day in silence except to answer a direct question. When you can hold your tongue, you can increase the control of your body. Now let us go to the next symbol. Now if you remember, the sumo wrestler was wearing a diamond studded watch. So what does that mean? So that watch in fact means that we have to respect our time. Look, I mean, time is your most precious commodity and it is non-renewable. Plan your days and take time to check you are balanced in the use of time, and you would not only feel far productive but far happier too. Don't make your life hectic by saying you lack time, because the thing you lack is just managing the time. Just take the time for all those things that makes you happy and simplify your life. Focus on your priorities and maintain balance. Always remember that enlightened people are priority driven. Again, I mean, there are good techniques given by the author. The first one is very very simple but most important. Have the courage to say no. Then the second technique is the deathbed mentality. Live every day as if it was your last. Imagine waking up every day and asking yourself the simple question, what would I do today if it was my last? Then think about how you would treat your family, your colleagues and even those who you do not know. Now friends, you know that the next symbol is, what is the next symbol? So you remember, right, that the sumo wrestler falls on the ground and then gradually he smells a beautiful rose and he gets up. So now what does that signify? Now that beautiful rose with wonderful fragrance signifies that we should selflessly serve others. A little bit of fragrance always clings to the hand that gives you roses. When you work to improve the life of others, you indirectly elevate your own life. The noblest thing you can do is to give others. No matter what have you achieved, no matter how bulky is your bank balance, no matter how many cars you own, the quality of life will come down to the quality of your contribution. So try to give people anything you have. It might be helping them with money, with wisdom, or with anything you are capable of. We were born crying while the whole world was rejoicing, but we should live our life in such a way that when we die, the whole world cries while we are rejoicing. Now there are few techniques which the author has explained for that. And first technique is give to those who ask. Whenever somebody asks, make sure that you give them something. And the second one is cultivate rich relationships. You make sure that you live in a very very good environment and develop good relationship with people. So now, do you remember the last symbol? So what happened? I mean, once the sumo wrestler, he got the beautiful fragrance, he got up and then he gradually walked towards that road. Now what does that signify? Going towards the road, it signifies that we should embrace the present. Live in the now. Just do the things you have to do right now. Don't delay the things you want wholeheartedly to the future. People ruin their present either frowning about past or thinking a lot about the future. The best day to do something is right now. Happiness is the journey and not the destination. Again, there are few techniques. First one is that we should live our children's childhood. Take the time to watch them grow and flourish. The best gift you could ever give to your children is your love. Get to know your children. Show them that they are far more important to you than the fleeting rewards of your professional career. Pretty soon, they will be off building lives and families of their own. If you do not, you are your children's childhood, then it will be too late. The time will be gone. The second technique is that we should practice gratitude. Count your blessings every time you wake up and before you go to bed. And third technique is that grow your destiny. We all have something that we are meant to do. Your genius will shine through and happiness will fill your life. The instant you discover your higher purpose and then direct all your energies towards it. Once you are connected to this mission, whether it is being a great teacher of children or an inspired artist, all your desires will be fulfilled effortlessly. Simply follow the path of your dreams in full expectation of the bounty that is certain to flow. This will bring you to your divine destination. So that's it, friends. I have given you the review, the gist of the book, The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari. I hope that you have liked this video. Thank you.